If we were to throw a brick into the Mariana Trench, how long would it take for the brick to sink to the deepest part of the Mariana Trench? First, let's understand how terrifying the Mariana Trench is. Everyone knows that the highest mountain in the world is Mount Everest, with an altitude of 8,848 meters. The Mariana Trench, on the other hand, is the deepest place on Earth, with a depth of 11,000 meters. There's a term in physics called atmospheric pressure. When you put your hand into water, the deeper you go, the more pressure you feel. Typically, for every 10 meters increase in water depth, there is an increase of 1 atmosphere of pressure. With the depth of the Mariana Trench being 11,000 meters, this means that at the deepest point it would endure 1,100 atmospheres of pressure. To put it more intuitively, imagine placing an object weighing 1.1 tons at your fingertip. Can you imagine that feeling? When a brick falls into the sea, it is subjected to pressure from all directions, so it experiences average compression. This actually helps prevent the brick from being crushed directly. Additionally, the material structure of the brick is relatively porous, allowing seawater to gradually penetrate its interior, balancing the pressure inside and outside the brick. Therefore, the brick may not necessarily be crushed directly. Now let's return to the original question. How long would it take for the brick to reach the deepest part of the Mariana Trench? Assuming the mass of the brick is 2.5 kilograms, combined with the density of seawater and the coefficient of water resistance, calculations based on formulas suggest that the average descent speed of the brick is approximately 2 meters per second. Descending 11,000 kilometers would require 5,500 seconds. However, this is just a theoretical estimate and actual conditions may vary. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for more content on incredible places around the world. See you next time.